Hi, it's Rob from the Bobsphere, and we've got this second Booker novel finished. Woo! Okay, so this is, and please, I know I'll probably get the pronunciation wrong, Ayobami Adebayo. It's her second novel, A Spell of Good Things. And I enjoyed it. There. That's the definite. Okay, so the plot. Two narratives, two main protagonists. Again, I'm going to have to do the pronunciation. I keep on forgetting them. So, yes, Enyola, if I am pronouncing it correctly, is a teenager. His father, due to the political situation in Nigeria, is unemployed. He was a teacher, which means that there isn't any income coming in. So, fees aren't paid, rent is not paid, and this is stressing. This is stressing Eniola out. And he tries to, well, I wouldn't say help out, but find different means. We'll go into that later. Now, the other one is Warayola, if I'm pronouncing it correctly, is a newly graduated doctor. She is going to marry Kunle. But the problem is that Kunle is abusive. We find that out in the middle of the book. Don't say it's a spoiler because you kind of get hints of what type of person he is right from the beginning. It's only, when he lands the first punch, you kind of expect it, or slap in this case. Anyway, Wariola, if I'm pronouncing, yeah, okay, I've repeated that. Kind of, she doesn't really like him, but she knows as a political move, it's a good one. Because her families get along together and will strengthen it. Now, the problem occurs when Uriola's father comes and asks her dad, sorry, am I, sorry, when Kunle's father comes and asks Uriola's dad to financially support him in his political campaign. The thing is that her father is already giving money to a, I wouldn't say a rival, another one. And he can be very vengeful. But as their families are come together, he's going to consider it. This causes a lot of problems, which reach a conclusion towards the end to see how bad power can be. As for Eniola, he starts working for that rival politician as part of his ranks to carry out certain duties. I'll let you figure that out. So, destinies of these two main characters do meet. They cross, I would say, faintly. It's not like they team up or anything that's like that. They just, they just cross each other. But the main point is it's about the different types of politics. I mean, you've got, the politics that have to do with the government, and I've explained that with voting, where your loyalties lay and how that can change your destination and ruin it. And then there's family politics. Nigerian tradition that you have a certain you have to please your parents. Let's say if your parents want you to be doctors, then it's best to be a doctor. And this is the stress that Wariola feels. She has done everything that her parents wanted, while her siblings have rebelled, and they're not that highly looked in their eyes. Even though there are some it faintly, each child feels differently about it, but as the reader, you can tell that they are proud of Oriolo. Oriola. 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 If I'm sorry about that, please excuse me. So the book, so I've spoken about family politics and traditions. And there's gender politics as well. There's the Wariola and her marriage to Kunle, the abusive Kunle. It's a very rich novel. It's got many layers. It does take its time to start, though. Do bear that in mind. It's like a you're pushing a rolled up carpet very slowly. But in that time, Adu Ayobami Adebayo is slowly creating her characters and making them more lifelike. These are very rich characters. They have their flaws and they have their good points, and we see how they react in every single situation. It scrutinizes on that. And I really enjoyed that. I really enjoyed the political theme, and I really enjoyed how it all played out. And I did like the fact that their characters just only met so slightly. It takes away a lot of cliches. Like I said, I have positive things to say about that. And it does pick up. The last 30 pages or so are heartbreaking. And I'll tell you that they just get you right over there. You kind of see it way off, but I didn't see it as drastic, I'll admit. I won't say what happens. I'll leave that up to you. So if you do like a slow burn, and I have a little feeling that this year's Booker novels are all slow burns. If you like a slow burn, I like them. This is for you. Just like in Ascension was a slow burn. It takes its time. This one takes its time. But it is rewarding. Both books are rewarding. So at this point, even though I'm only two books in, my Booker journey seems to be a good one. It just will take a little bit more time than usual. But that doesn't matter. Okay, that's it for me. See you until the next book.